Hello friends, today I am here to discuss a technical session in the field of computer science having a subject OOPS and C++. When we say about OOPS and C++, it means the C++ programming language which is incorporating the rich features of object-oriented programming in the form of OOP. The two important concepts which is a main topic of discussion for today's technical session is containership and inheritance. The very first key question is, what is the main difference between the inheritance and containership? My dear students, inheritance is a concept which allows you in using the properties cum methods of an existing class in a new class. Or in other words, inheritance is one of the features of object-oriented programming in C++ language, where a new class, which is also known as a subclass or a child class, is inheriting the properties cum methods of its old class cum superclass cum parent class. While in extracting some properties cum methods from the existing class by the new class, it will cover its objective of doing certain tasks cum functionality, which helps that new class in doing that activity in a very flexible cum simpler manner. So this is the whole concept about the inheritance. But when we say about the second concept, that is containership, the very first key question is, what do you mean by the term containership? Basically, it is the concept of C++ programming which basically describes the ownership between the associated objects. When we say about describing the ownership between the associated objects, a very question arises at this stage, like, what do you mean by the term objects? Objects are the entities. Objects describes the attributes cum properties of a respective class. Objects are the instance of class. Whenever we create an object of one class into another, then that object will become a member of the class. This type of relationship between the classes is known as containership. An interesting point is that containership is having a has a kind of relationship where a one class contains the object of the another class. The object that is part of another class is called contained object, whereas the object that contains the another object as its part or attribute is called container object. The very another differences which can be make more clearer to you between the containership and inheritance is via some example. When I say in the case of a containership that features of existing class are wanted inside your new class but not its interface, then by this technical definition of exemplary containership, I want to state, like, for example, computer system has a hard disk in which I have been highlighting the computer system specifically about its component, that is hard disk. I am not talking about its main interface mechanism. Simply, another example of containership can be that a car has an engine, comma chassis, comma steering wheels. I am just highlighting the features of the car without incorporating the actual interface mechanism of that vehicle car. So this is the real life examples of the containership. But when we say about the term inheritance as an exemplary way, then the technical definition of exemplary of inheritance concept is when you want to force the new type to be of the same type of the base class. For example, car is a vehicle. In this, I have been stating that the type of that car as a class, which is a vehicle, which is the concept of inheritance. Another example is computer system is an electronic device. Again, computer system is a class which has been stating by a specific type, which is resembling the new type, which is of same type of the base class, that is, it is an electronic device. Let's take a program example of container ship, which make you more clear come understandable about the container ship activity. The general syntax for container ship is class, class name. Here the class, class name, the first is the name of the class name, and this is the class definition. How I came to know this is the class definition? While mentioning class keyword and the class name as first, the starting and ending braces has been terminated with a semicolon symbol. This is the indicator of the class definition. Next, in the same program, I have used another class, that class, class name. And since it is a different class, so I have mentioned the different class name as second. In this second class definition, I have mentioned the object of the first class. That is the name of the class first, and then I have created an object. I have created an object simply while typing F. In this example, we generally stating the way how we are stating the container ship syntax in the C++ programming platform. The example which basically describes the detailed container ship activity in C++ is this example. Example 1, where I have been incorporating the concept of container ship in the C++ platform. Starting with the very first statement, I have used the preprocessor statements and using the namespace. Here the namespace is an identifier which describes the all the properties, come methods, the variable which I've been using. These all things respective are a part of namespace declaration come definition. When we use using namespace std standard, it means namespace is talking about that identifier which is including the various functions, methods, variables you are using in the respective program. To provide a compatibility aspects, we declare come define in the header section of the C++ program. Starting with the very first part, class, class name. Here the first is the class name in which I have used access specifier public. Then I have declared between these class definition of first class the member functions. Here showf is the member function which has the associated statements of output statement. Simply I have mentioned hello from first class. After covering the class definition of the first class, I move to the second class, class second, which is the class known as container class because it is containing the properties come methods of the first class. How we came to know? This is the line of example where it is clearly indicating that this is a class which is known as container class, who is taking the properties come methods of the first class. Like the very first name of the class is first, which is a part of its earlier stated class definition. And here F is, we have created the object with the name F. Now while declaring the object creation as an F, we move further with the help of member function declaration. Here we have used a member function second. Since the name of that function is similar to the name of the class name, so this is a type of function which is known as constructor function. My dear friends, we have discussed earlier also, but for this session I'll make you reminder call. Constructors are used for creating some objects, and the very important thing is like that, to understood the constructor functionality or the constructor syntax, the name of the constructors are similar to that of the class name. That is the clear indicator which makes that function different from an ordinary come normal function. So since this is the name of the function, which is similar to the name of the class name, that's why it has been known as constructor function, and we are using constructor function for creating an objects. In this constructor function, we have taken that object f which have we recently created in the second class. With the help of dot com member operator, we have used a method name, that is function name showf, and this is the way which we are doing a method calling activity. Once that thing has been done, with the help of method calling definition by the second class, we close the definition of this second class also, that is a container class, while terminating it with a semicolon symbol. Finally, it's the time for calling our methods, functions, come class definition, which we have declared, come defined in our previous section of the current program. In this main function, we have mentioned the name of the second class name, that is the second class name is container class name, and then we have mentioned the name of the object, and after creating an object, we have closed the main function. So in this complete program, my dear friend, we are using a class second, which is having an object of class first. So this is another type of inheritance we are witnessing, in which the type of inheritance is known as has a kind of relationship, because in this we are saying that second class has an object of the first class as its member. You can see here also, like the second class has an object of the as a member of the first class, the first class which we are talking. So with this respective things, I want to make it clear like how the container class is taking the beautiful feature of OOPS concept in accomplishing a certain goal come task come activity, where we are able to do some kind of extraction of methods come features without talking much about the interface. In short, container class, as I just told you earlier also, repeating it once again for your remembrance, that it is the class in which the object that is part of an another object is called contain object, whereas the object that contains another object as a part of its attribute is called container object. With these words, I'll just try to make you clear understanding like how and what situation container class, which is working similar to the concept of inheritance class, but with major difference, is like it is using the features of existing class which are wanted inside of a new class, but not covering as a whole its interface. It is just considering the existing features only, rather than considering the complete interface of the existing class. So in that kind of situation, where we want certain features come methods without exactly the whole interface of the existing class in the new class, we proceed for the concept of containership, which makes our program more flexible, simpler, faster, dynamically approachable programmer, as well as the chances of errors are also very much less or low while using the concept of containership, and as well as using the concept of inheritance also. So I hope so the main differences between the containership and inheritance has been clear to you with this technical session. The next session we will discuss with some more beautiful features and characteristics of OOPS concept and C++ programming. Please be in touch if you found any issues or confusion regarding some another new topic or the existing topic. Then you may approach to me via the email ID shaktikundu@gmail.com. That's all for now. Thank you so much. Bye bye. Take care.